وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه. إن شاء الله تعالى, today we'll talk about, it's also part of أصول التفسير, the importance of some surahs of the Quran and the high status of some surahs in the Quran above other surahs. And one of the most important surah in the Quran, that is Surah Al-Baqarah. There is no, as you know, if you remember when we used to talk about the Usul al-Hadith and that some people fabricated some hadith about the virtues of each surah in the Quran. No, not every surah has a hadith from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that whoever recites this surah will get this, and whoever recites. But the hadith in general that about the entire Quran. The Prophet said, "من قرأ حرفا من كتاب الله فله بكل حرف حسنة." Whoever recites from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, any part, for each letter he will get one good deed. For each letter, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will multiply it into 10 good deeds until whatever he subhanahu wa ta'ala wills. But there are some surahs in the Quran, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did mention a hadith about that. And one of them is Surah Al-Baqarah. Surah Al-Baqarah is a very important surah for each one of us to learn it. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said one of the ahadith, we mentioned the ahadith that he mentioned about Surah Al-Baqarah. لا تجعلوا بيوتكم قبورا فإن البيت الذي تقرأ فيه سورة البقرة لن يدخله الشيطان. The Prophet said, do not turn your houses into graves. Why into graves? Because do not turn your houses into graves because the graves is a place where we do not recite Quran over there. Or we are not allowed to pray over there. So the Prophet said in the hadith, do not turn your houses like graves by not praying in it or by not reciting the Quran in it. For shaitan does not enter a house where Surah Al-Baqarah is recited. Shaitan does not enter a house where Surah Al-Baqarah is recited. Another hadith, it's a statement of Ibn Mas'ud, he said, Shaitan flees from the house where Surah Al-Baqarah is heard. Another hadith said from Ibn Mas'ud, said, Shaitan departs from the house where Surah Al-Baqarah is recited, and while leaving, he passes gas. Because he cannot stay in a place where Surah Al-Baqarah is recited. Anyone who memorizes Surah Al-Baqarah, because when we talk about Surah Al-Baqarah, whether by reading it or memorizing it, the ulama said both are wrong, whether you memorize it or you read it, no one can harm him. No one can harm him. Especially about the magic and this stuff, if anyone has Surah Al-Baqarah in his heart, magicians cannot reach him. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "أخذها بركة وتركها حسرة ولا تستطيعها السحرة." لا تستطيعها السحرة. أخذها بركة means learning. There is a blessing in learning the Surah Al-Baqarah. And there is a sorrow, regret in ignoring it. And the magicians cannot reach Surah Al-Baqarah. In another way, magicians cannot memorize or learn Surah Al-Baqarah. Because Surah Al-Baqarah cannot go with Surah Al-Baqarah and magic at the same time cannot be in a person's heart. And the Prophet said, إِنَّ لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ سِنَامٍ وَسِنَامُ الْقُرْآنِ سُورَةُ الْبَقَرَةِ. Everything has a high peak And Surah Al-Baqarah is the high peak of the Quran. The Sinam, Sinam meaning, you know, the Sinam al-Jamal, the thing that on top of the camel's back. This is Sinam. This is Sinam because this it's the hump, because it's the highest spot in the camel's back. And Surah Al-Baqarah, subhanAllah, similar to the Quran, it is the Sinam of the Quran, meaning the top or the highest surah, or it takes the highest level among the surahs or among the book of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, we saw Surah Al-Baqarah during the day, then shaitan will not enter the house for 3 days. And whoever recites Surah Al-Baqarah during the night, shaitan will not enter the house for 3 nights. One day the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam sent an expedition force comprising a number of the Sahaba, number of that Sahaba. Ali sallallahu alaihi wasallam wanted to appoint someone to as a commander, as a leader. And he asked each one of them, what do you have from the Quran? And each one of them mentioned some that he memorized this part and this part. Until sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to the youngest one of them. And he said, what have you memorized from the book of Allah? He said, I memorized such and such a source and Surah Al-Baqarah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, do you have Surah Al-Baqarah? He said, yes, I have Surah Al-Baqarah. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم اذهب فأنت أميرهم. Go, you are the Amir, you are the leader. And he was the youngest. A man from the Sahaba stood up and he said, Ya Rasulullah, by Allah, the reason I did not learn the Surah Al-Baqarah, because out of fear that I wouldn't be able to implement it. Because Surah Al-Baqarah contains the largest number of rules and commands in the Quran. Look, subhanAllah, I said, Ya Rasul, the only way I stayed away from learning Surah Al-Baqarah, out of fear that I wouldn't be able to implement it. So look how, subhanAllah, it's not, as we said, about memorizing, but it's about understanding the Quran and implementing in the book of Allah, subhanAllah. All these ahadith, subhanAllah, will mention about the status of Surah Al-Baqarah. Another hadith mentioned that Usayd ibn Hudayr, this is a famous hadith in Sahih Muslim, and the Adab al-Mufrad in Bukhari. He said one day, Usayd ibn Hudayr, the Sahab, was reading during the night, reciting, and the horse was tied next to him. So every time he recites, he was reciting Surah Al-Baqarah, his horse started moving, jumping. He stops, the horse stops. He started reading, the horse started jumping around. So his son was, Yahya was very close to him. So he stopped reciting the Quran out of fear that the horse might harm his son or step on him. He looked at the sky and he saw a cloud with like lamps, like very radiating, shining cloud. During that time of his recitation, in the morning, he went to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Salat al-Fajr, and he told him the story. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Tilka al-malaika danat li sama'i sawtak." They are what you have seen. They are the angels who came to listen to your recitation of Surah Al-Baqarah. If you continue reading until the morning, then people would have been able to see the angels, and the angels will not be hiding from them. Can you imagine this? People would be, if you continue reading until the morning, then people would have been able to see the angels, and the angels wouldn't be hiding from them. And that the reason behind that, Surah Al-Baqarah in it, the master of the Quran. سيدة آية القرآن الكريم, which is آية 1, آية الكرسي. آية الكرسي is the master of the Quran, because سيدة آية القرآن الكريم. And when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, asked أبي بن كعب, and he said, يا أبي, ما أعظم آية في كتاب الله عز وجل. لو سبحان الله, this is will give you an example of understanding the book of Allah سبحانه. If I give you this book, read it, and I ask you, what is the best part in this book? You will not bring, if even if you give it to 10, 15 people, everyone will get different part. I like this part more. I like this part. Obey bin Ka'b said, the Prophet said, and asked him, what is that? What is the best ayah in the Quran? So, and the Quran contains more than 6,236 ayah and more than 600 pages. Can you marry this Ibn Ubayy bin Ka'b said? Rightly, because they understand to the book of Allah. He said, ayat al-kursi. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tapped on his chest and he said, لِيَهْنَكَ الْعِلْمُ أَبَى الْمُنْذِرِ. لِيَهْنَكَ الْعِلْمُ أَبَى الْمُنْذِرِ. His nickname, أَبَى الْمُنْذِرِ, meaning congratulations to your knowledge. The knowledge that you have. So subhanAllah, among 600 pages, he was able to tell the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the best ayah in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is how the Sahaba understood the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in it also the last ayat of course is number one, and the last two ayah of Surah Al-Baqarah. When Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يقول من قرأ بالآيتين من آخر سورة البقرة في ليلة كفتاة. Whoever recites the last two ayah from Surah Al-Baqarah, the last two ayah from Surah Al-Baqarah, or the last ayat, which is three ayahs, from لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ, from Surah Al-Baqarah in one night, it will suffice for him. Suffice for him meaning it will keep away any harm from him. And this ayah, this is from the things that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, especially the last two ayah, from the last three verses from Surah Al-Baqarah, was a gift from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was with Jibreel one day, and then Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam heard the sound above him, and Jibreel lifted his sight to the sky, and he said, Ya Muhammad, this is a door, just to open right now. And it was not open before. This is the door in the heaven opened for the first time, and it was not open before. An angel came through that door to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said, Abshir. Abshir meaning you have good news of receiving two lights which given to you and they were not given to any Prophet before you. And the two lights are, as the Hadith mentioned, Surah Al-Fatiha, the mother of the book, and also number two, the last two verses of Surah Al-Baqarah. And the Prophet, that the Jibreel alayhi salam said to the Prophet, every letter you read from the last verse of Surah Al-Baqarah, you will be granted its benefit. Every letter you read, you will be granted its benefit. So this is inshaAllah ta'ala something very important, plus Surah Al-Kahf, plus Surah Al-Waqi'ah. There is some surahs in the Quran, Surah Al-Mulk. Those surahs, inshaAllah ta'ala, you must learn them or recite them. Like Surah Al-Mulk, you recite it daily. Daily, every single day, open the Quran and recite Surah Al-Mulk. Because Surah Al-Mulk is Al-Munajjiyah. It is Al-Munajjiyah, no Al-Munajjiyah. The protector from what? From the punishment of the grave. From the punishment of the grave. And the Prophet said, وَدَدْتُ أَنَّهَا فِي قَلْبِ كُلِّ رَجُلٍ مِنْ أُمَّتِ. I wish that Surah Al-Mulk is in the heart of every single person of my ummah. So Surah Al-Mulk, you should not skip one night before reciting Surah Al-Mulk. You should not skip one night before reciting Surah Al-Waqi'ah. لَمْ تُصِبُ فَاقَةٌ أَبَدًا. Most of us who are complaining about poverty, about faqr, recite Surah Al-Waqi'ah. من حفظ عشر آيات من سورة الكهف العصمة من الدجال. The biggest fitna, whoever memorizes the first 10 verses of Surah Al-Kahf, then he will be protected and saved from an Masih al-Dajjal. So some surahs in the Quran, as we said, have high status and high rank above others than other surahs. And one of them is Surah Al-Baqarah, Surah Al-Imran, Al-Kahf, Al-Waqi'ah, Al-Mulk, and the last three surahs of the Quran, and definitely Surah Al-Fatiha is the mother of the book. So insha'Allah ta'ala, you must read these surahs, recite them, and understand them. Understand those surahs insha'Allah ta'ala, and spend some time to study some of the surahs of the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, insha'Allah, this is something very important, especially Surah Al-Fatiha. Even if you do not, if you don't have enough time to recite Surah Al-Fatiha, you can play Surah Al-Fatiha from the computer once every 3 days. Keep your house, inshallah ta'ala, safe from shaitan. As soon as you put Surah Al-Fatiha in the house, shaitan runs away from the house, has no place. He cannot stay in a place where Surah Al-Baqarah is recited, because Surah Al-Baqarah burns the shaitan. He cannot stay. So keep Surah Al-Baqarah in the house. Whether you recite it once each 3 days, or if you don't have time, if you don't memorize it, or if you are not able to recite Quran properly, then you can play it from YouTube or from the computer. But this is something, inshallah ta'ala, we must practice, and we must, inshallah, even for our kids, inshallah ta'ala. This is something for our kids. Yeah, keep always the house, inshallah. Keep your house always busy. Keep always let the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be mentioned in the house day and night. Do not turn your houses into graves. Always keep the house, whether busy with your salawat or nawafil, or busy with the recitation of the Quran, but always keep in mind that the house, all the time, inshallah, that it's always busy with the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and let the name of Allah be mentioned in the house 24/7. إن شاء الله تعالى نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يرزقنا وإياكم التوفيق والسلامة والإخلاص للقوم والعمل. اللهم اجعل القرآن الكريم ربيع قلوبنا، اللهم اجعل القرآن الكريم ربيع قلوبنا ونور أبصارنا وجلاء همومنا وأحزاننا. اللهم اجعله لنا في القبر مؤنسا وعلى الصراط نورا ويوم القيامة شفيعا، ويوم القيامة شفيعا. اللهم ذكرنا منه ما نسينا، وعلمنا منه ما جهلنا، وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وأطراف النهار على الوجه الذي يرضيك عنا يا رب العالمين. اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن، اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن، اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يقرؤون القرآن فيرقون، ولا تجعلنا من الذين يقرؤون القرآن فيشقون. اللهم اجعلنا من الذين يقرؤون القرآن فيرقون، ولا تجعلنا من الذين يقرؤون القرآن فيشقون. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين.